The In-House Show with Nikki, only on East Coast FM 107.6.
Hi, this is Kevin Mackay from Glasgow Underground, and you're listening to East Coast FM 107.6.
This is Nick from Sneaky Pete's. You're listening to Nikki on the In-House Show.
Good afternoon, and a very happy Friday to you all. Welcome to the In-House Show. It's Friday night. It's 5 o'clock. At five, we are live. It's the peak of the week. You know it. And it's the big show. It's the big one. Every month we do a big one. And it's tonight. It's happening. Five guests tonight. In the studio at the moment is our first guest. He's already here. We'll be talking to him shortly. Ben makes films. You may know him from Instagram. See his work around. And then we've got Zoe Carmichael and Kieran joining us later. Mark Smith, Koval DJ. And of course, Kirsty Carlisle will be here tonight. Finally, finally. Right, so, Ben Falconer, how are you doing?
I'm not bad, mate. I'm not bad. I'm happy to be here.
That's good. Thank you very much for coming. So some of you may be wondering who Ben is. What is he doing? Why is he here? Ben's a photographer. Do you do a bit of videography as well?
Kind of like blend of both, aye. Filmmaking, photography, aye. Just off of cameras.
That's good. A blendable. I've invited Ben here tonight to welcome and to introduce him to our community of clubbers, ravers and music lovers. Ben is best known for his photography and videography spanning multiple genres and subjects. Personally, I know Benjamin for his work within the club and festival scene and shooting incredible live imagery of events all across Scotland. So with all of Ben's experience within the industry, I thought he might like to come and share some of his stories and moments from many, many years behind the camera. So Ben, introduce yourself, tell the listeners who you are, where you're from, how old you are, all that.
I'm Ben. Ben makes films. I'm from Edinburgh. 25, just turned 25 3 weeks ago. So getting halfway to 50, feeling the age now. Back's starting to go and all that. Right, so. Get about it, see how it goes.
Wait till you get to my age. You'll know all about it. So how long have you been behind the camera?
About seven, 8 years now. Kind of just, I've just seen how it goes, seen what it takes me.
How did it start? What was the, what made you pick up a camera?
I guess I always liked kind of running about with cameras in that kind of young age. Mum and dad had cameras in the house and stuff like that, so I was always taking photos of the cat, taking photos of the telly, whatever caught my eye, and it kind of just transpired. I went to film school in Edinburgh, that was kind of the interest, and obviously, kind of hand in hand as you're growing up, you're going out into the clubs and stuff like that, so I kind of just thought, we'll take the camera into the club and see what happens, and it kind of just transpired from there.
See how it progresses. Well, your shots are pretty good, man, and it seems to be very popular as well. So those few shots, those early shots, have opened a lot of doors for you, haven't they?
Apparently so, I don't know. I never really thought that it was going to turn out the way that it did, but I guess you've got to kind of just keep cracking on and eventually things will pick up. People kind of become aware, especially online nowadays. You know, you've got the opportunity to kind of share your work and let people see what you're about and what you've got to offer.
It's easy to put yourself out there now, isn't it? You've got the platforms.
I think it is easy to put yourself out there now, but it takes, kind of, you've got probably a little, kind of in your introduction phase, you've got to get over it a little bit. I can, you know, for a lot of people, there's probably nerves and stuff that come with it, but once you kind of get to the groove, and if people, you know, receive, you know, take the stuff in well, then it kind of gives you a little boost to just keep going.
Why not? If it works, double down and keep going.
Just keep playing.
Keep going. So tell us about some of the gigs and some of the promoters and people you've been involved with. Give out a bit of name drop. It's time for a bit of bragging. Let's come on.
I guess, you know, I'll start off, shout out to the boy. Well, Mark's going to be here later, obviously. What Goes Up was an old collective, kind of back 2019, 2020, pre-COVID. They were kind of running parties in the Mash House and stuff like that. That's kind of where it all started. And from there, I mean, guess most recently, kind of been running with a, kind of do pickups or fly. Shout out Cammy as well. Cammy Stambeside kind of operates out of Sneaky Pete's on a Monday night. That was a mainstay probably for the past couple of years. I've always been there on a Monday, you know, on every month. But I kind of between fly, some stuff with the Alation Boys, and obviously from Trinet, Easy Street nowadays, kind of they're taking off. And I'm kind of running about with them a lot of the time, seeing what the boys get up to.
But you're moving into new territories now, aren't you? You're trying to expand out a bit and step into a few different genres of photography, aren't you?
It was always the goal, but obviously kind of the club stuff was taken off, so it made sense to kind of operate in that area, but now kind of pushing out there, touching, kind of moving into different areas, especially kind of running stuff with Bems out of Glasgow, you know, a good mate of mine now, and a couple of, you know, trying to get into like stuff with bands and stuff like that. I'm interested in music generally, so I've got no problem kind of just venturing into new stuff. So
a gig's a gig.
Exactly.
It's all good. It's all there for the taking, isn't it? So you get called and asked to appear at some of these events, don't you?
People just get in contact, whatnot. Which was never how it started, you know. I was getting in touch with people going, "Can I please come with a camera?" And most of them were going, "No." But, you know, as time has kind of transpired, it's ended up that people are coming to me going, "Do you want to come along to this? Bring your camera, see what happens."
So where can people find you? How can they get in touch with you?
Well, you've got at Ben Makes Films on Instagram. That's kind of the mainstay. That's where all the stuff's going up. And you've got benmakesfilms.net. There you go, that's a website. I've not updated it in a while, but there's stuff there if you want to have a look, so crack on.
You can contact me.
Definitely, I'm there.
He's there. He's available for work. Give him a shout. Ben Makes Films. So, for the tech geeks out there, what kind of setup are you usually working with?
I'm running a Sony camera just now. I like running with the Sony camera. It's good for the video and the photos and all stuff. But I like kind of playing with kind of older, I guess now, vintage kind of camera wear. Old camcorders, old kind of point and shoot. Little, you know, it's coming popular now. People running about with little digital cameras to take photos of their mates. But, I mean, some of these cameras still produce kind of good images and stuff like that. And I think it gives it a nice feel. Especially with those, you can't just hold the trigger and take 100 photos in a second. You know, you've got to pick your moments. So yeah. It's kind of presents a new challenge and the stuff looks good, so.
A bit more of an art form.
I would say so. There's definitely a bit more intent applied when you're using stuff that doesn't kind of keep up to the pace that you want it to with the new stuff, definitely.
So how often do you go out and you just get lucky and you just get those shots like straight away? And what's it like when it doesn't happen? Like, do photographers get artist block? Like, does that thing?
You can definitely get into a creative block, I think. I think I've been through it a couple of times now, but it's just sometimes you're doing a lot of the same stuff. And you just kind of want to pause. So it's nice to, you know, you can kind of just send yourself out and go and take photos of something else or go and film something else. And it kind of brings you back in because you end up missing it. And I think, especially when you're working with kind of new promotions, new artists and stuff like that, they're coming with their own sound. They're coming with their own personality. And it kind of gives you a little kick up the backside to kind of remember why you're in it. Because these people are coming up. They're trying to kind of show stuff off. And it's your job to kind of also exemplify that for the work that you're doing. So
showcase and highlight what they're doing and show them in the best light.
Aye, definitely.
Because it's not easy to show yourself in all of the lights, is it, as an artist? Like, you can't be a performer and take photos of yourself.
You do
rely on people taking good shots of you, and those shots can be career-changing, can't they? They can open the doors, they can make the telephone ring. Like, it does make a difference to people's...
I think you see it a lot more now on social media, where you kind of got people that are getting into it, and are maybe just depending on photos taken, or photos and videos taken by their friends and stuff like that. But I think there's definitely kind of an impact there when you've got a real kind of piece of quality to kind of showcase what you're doing. I think it maybe just demonstrates to everyone else that you're taking yourself seriously and you're backing yourself by kind of investing in that type of stuff. So, yeah, it's definitely worth it.
Nice. Cool. Right, I think we should play a track, and then when we come back, we're going to get a little nomination. Ben's a guest tonight, so he deserves a nomination like everybody else. So, as I said at the start of the show, Diana Ross would have been 80 this week. I don't think house music would have been the same without her. She's given so many influence to so many artists. So let's celebrate her 80th birthday this week by playing a few tracks. This is Tenderness by Diana Ross on East Coast FM. Celebrating her 80th birthday, or at least she would have. Diana Ross, Tenderness. Funky on a Friday. Right, we're going to say thank you very much to Ben for joining us this evening. Ben, it's been great chatting to you. Just a nomination from you now. Who's going to step up to the challenge?
I'll nominate Christian Rogers at the basket.
Christian Rogers. That is a good shout, and I hope he steps up to it.
He's on the come up, and he's just got no tune out, so I'm sure that he was there.
He's a legend in the game, so I hope he's up for the challenge, and Christian will be in touch with you soon. So, Ben, thank you very much. Really appreciate you coming and taking the time tonight. You're welcome to hang around as long as you like. He'll be taking a few shots, no doubt, so if he sends those over, we'll be posting those on the social media pages. And if you didn't catch that, it's Ben Makes Films, so go and give him a look. Go and give him a follow. His work is tremendous. Right, we're going to do one more tune, and we're going to speak to Zoe and Kieran.
107.6. This is East Coast FM.